Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in today's video, we will be talking about the population ecology. Basically, we'll be dealing with the population characteristics. There are basically six characteristics and today we'll be talking about two of them, that is size and density and dispersion. So without wasting any time, let's get started. Before talking about the characteristics of population, let us see what is a population. So it is a group of individuals of a particular species. The individuals are of a specific species that are inhabiting the same area at a specific time. So this is the definition of a population, that is they should be of the same species first, they should live in the same area second, and also they should be living in that area at a specific period of time, right? Now there are basically six characteristics of population. First one is size and density, then dispersion, age structure, mortality, natality, and also life tables. So today we'll be dealing with these two, the size and density and dispersion, right? So let's start. So first one is the size of the population. So it is generally expressed as the number of individuals of a population. Also, if the number of individuals are many in number and they are very small in size, they could be expressed in the form of biomass of that population. That can also be called as the size of the population. For example, if phytoplanktons, we are talking about the phytoplanktons, they could be expressed as the biomass of the individuals, right? There are certain factors which affect the size of the population. They are, first is resource availability, that is how much resources are available for the species to survive there. For example, the food or certain minerals or sunlight or any type of resource. Second is the competition. So there are two kinds of competition, you already know, that is interspecific between two species and also intraspecific between a particular species. For example, you can see here deer. They will be having intraspecific competition among themselves. Then there is parasitism and predation. If they are predated by some predator, their number will reduce. If there are more number of predators, then if they are attacked by some parasites, their number may reduce. Or if there are less parasites, their number may flourish. So these are the factors that affect the population size. Next is the density, right? We have talked about the size, also the density comes in the same topic. So what is the density of a population? It is number of individuals of a species per unit area. We are talking about the number of individual species per unit area. We are dividing it by the area in which it is residing. Now there are two types of densities. First one is the crude density, second is the ecological density. There is a very simple difference between the two. We'll first see the definition, then we'll understand it by a diagram. So the crude density is nothing but it is per unit total space. Whatever total space of that area is present, it will be divided by that. And ecological density is nothing but it is per unit of habitat space. The space in which the organism or the species is actually inhabiting, that will be divided by the number of individuals, right? Now we'll see it by a diagram, you'll understand it clearly then. So for example, this is a habitat, this is the total habitat, right? If we are considering the total habitat, then it will be crude density. If we are dividing it by the total habitat that is present, it will be crude density. Now there is this much of space in which the organism is actually residing. There are no organisms of that species in this area. So we are just taking the amount of area in which it is actually residing. So then it will be called as the ecological density. I hope you have understood it. Now the population size. What all factors on which the population size depends. First is the birth. Because of birth, the population size will increase. It will be added on, right? B is nothing but the, we are just representing birth by small b. We'll write a formula after that. So for that understanding, the small b is here, right? So if there are more number of individuals that are taking, the births are taking place, then the population size will increase. It will be added on to that. then if deaths are happening, if organisms are dying, then it will be reduction in the population size. Next is immigration. If more number of species from some area are immigrating, are migrating to that area, then what will happen is it will be added on to that area. And also if they are emigrating, right? Immigration is happening, then what will happen is the number of individuals will reduce. That is, they are moving from that area to some other area. What is immigration? It is nothing but the organisms are coming from some area to that area, right? They are migrating to that area. And emigration is they are migrating from that area. They are moving outside. So the number of population size will reduce in the case of emigration, and in the case of emigration, it will increase. So what is the formula then of the population size? It is nothing but R is equals to R represents the change in the population, whatever change is taking place in the population. So it is B plus I, that is birth and immigration, we are adding that, and then we are reducing it by deaths and immigration, right? So this makes up the total change in the population. Now if there is a positive change in the population, then the size is increasing, and if there is negative change in the population, then the size is decreasing of that population, right? So it is very clearly understood. I hope you have understood the formula. Remember this formula very clearly, and also the difference between immigration and emigration. Now the second topic that we have to talk about is dispersion. So what is dispersion? It is the pattern of spacing among individuals within a geographical boundary. The way the organisms are spaced among each other in a geographical boundary is known as dispersion. So basically dispersion is of three types. The first one is the uniform distribution or dispersion. It is nothing but in which individuals are more or less equally spaced. They are equally spaced from one another. You can see in the diagram that one is here, another one is here, right? They are equally spaced from one another. This doesn't happen normally because the organisms are not aligned like this in the ecosystem. But in the example of croplands, that is, we are growing it artificially. So it is a kind of uniform distribution dispersion. Now the second type of dispersion that we see is random dispersion. As the name itself is clear, position of each individual is independent of others. That is, it is not related to the other individual of that population, and it is randomly distributed. One is here, one is here, it can be anywhere, right? So in the case of dispersed seeds that are dispersed by either wind or that is dispersed by water, this type of dispersion is shown, right? Now the last type, the third type is the clumped dispersion. The clumped dispersion is aggregated into patches. The individuals are aggregated into patches that you see in the diagram here. It is the social aggregation, or they have the favorable conditions to live in that area, and then they live with each other. For example, the elephants. What happens in the elephants is it is a social aggregation that they have, and they try to live in clumps or in clusters or in groups, right? So these were the three types of dispersions. First is the random, clumped, and also the uniform dispersion. I hope you have understood the lesson, and if you have liked the content, do hit the like button. If you have any questions or queries, or if you have to give any feedback, you can definitely comment in the comment section. Also share the video with your friends whoever are preparing for this exam, and subscribe to the channel for more such informative videos. Thank you so much.